God's Not Dead is just a terrible movie. If you could even call it a movie. I don't even know how this got a theatrical release. It's one of those movies that belongs on Lifetime or LMN. Now I'm gonna say this right off the bat. The reasons I hate this movie, for the most part, have nothing to do with religion. There is no religious bias here. The reason this movie sucks has nothing to do with religion. Well, it does, kind of. But I'll get into that later. I'm not going to tell you whether I'm a Christian or a Muslim or an atheist, because that's none of your concern, really. But I would call this movie offensive. It's pandering to their audience, and the movie is very one-sided. So if you're Christian and you agree with everything this movie says, good for you. But I won't be praising the movie because it promotes your beliefs. That's not what I do. This review is in no way trying to insult your religion, even though my audience knows I have no problem with offending people. It's kind of what I do. But talking about religion isn't my forte. So this is just an honest review. You know what? Why am I even explaining myself? These people are gonna fucking dislike the video anyway. The opening scene. The second this movie starts, it instills a sense of dread. Not like The Shining. See, The Shining, with its eerie music and its camera work, sets the tone for the entire movie. The sense of dread established here is not intentional. The second the movie starts, you go, "Oh shit, this movie's gonna suck." It's not easy, no, finding the words to say when you're feeling lost, you'll find your way. The world is so broken, it sometimes it leaves. Poor editing, poor acting, terrible staging, overbearing music. Oh, look at all these pretty people. Aren't they all happy with their lives? Wow, great editing there.
Name? Wheaton. Josh Wheaton.
Yeah, you wish. Pretty much every problem with this opening scene is every problem I have with the movie. I mean, just look at it. I don't even have to say anything. The acting. Now, I don't know whether or not to blame the actors, because based on what I've seen, this director isn't very good, and the script isn't very good, and the characters they're given aren't very well written. Maybe they're trying the best they can, but for the most part, the acting in this movie is just really, really bad.
My chicken. I don't know when was the last time I had chicken.
That would be yesterday. For lunch and dinner.
Are you serious? I don't think that she should have the same thing every...
You think of anything else gonna make her that happy?
There's a point I draw the line and just go, no, these people can't act. Some of them, maybe, they could act. I've never seen these actors in anything else. But when you're trying to tell a dramatic story about people who don't believe in God, and the story of a woman who gets cancer, or the story of a young girl who becomes an independent woman, you need decent actors. Because when you have dramatic scenes with terrible actors, it is the most unintentionally funny thing in the world.
I think I have cancer. Did you hear me?
It's embarrassing. All right, here's your big scene. Okay, cry. Nope, not there yet. You almost got it. Almost got it. There you go, just keep trying. No tears, you're almost there, don't worry. Okay, don't worry. Still no tears. Do you have like scleroderma? Amy, do you have scleroderma?
No.
The director. If you don't have a good director, the movie's not gonna come out good. End of story.
You're beautiful.
Who the fuck
are you?
I'm sure the script was bad too. I know. I've seen movies with bad scripts before that the director can work around and make better. He does not do that. Everything is flat. While directors usually try to work in details and stuff to make the film more interesting, he makes no attempt to do this. There is nothing subtle about this movie. He makes sure every point is blatantly clear. No room for interpretation, no room to let the audience think for themselves.
What you're teaching here isn't philosophy. It's not even atheism anymore. What you're teaching is anti-theism. It's not enough that you don't believe. You need all of us to not believe with you.
Why don't you admit the truth? You just want to ensnare them in your primitive superstition.
What I want is for them to make their own choice. That's what God wants.
How hypocritical is that? Think for yourselves. Why don't you make a movie where the audience can think for themselves? There is only one detail in this whole movie that I could appreciate. During this debate scene, these two are arguing. Notice the teacher has a microphone with him. The student does not. The teacher is making an attempt to take away the student's voice. However, the student yells his beliefs and is able to make a statement, even though the teacher did everything in his power to make sure that it could not be heard. This is something subtle. Thank you for including one subtle thing in your whole movie.
Wow, that's perfect.
Stereotypes. I'm sorry, when you're making a drama and there is not one interesting character, you failed. Human dramas need to be complex. The characters need to be complex. They need to change over the course of the film. When every character is a stereotype, we are not engaged in what's going on.
Mr. Dawkins and Mr. Chomsky are still very much alive. Mr.
G-Dog, Gerard Trigger.
Are you fucking kidding me? Gee, I wonder if this guy's a slacker. I can't really tell.
I'm out.
Wow. Holy shit. Do you even know what subtle means?
I guess when you say you, you're referring to the whole group of my family, which would be y'all. You could just change it to y'all, that'd be easier. We can certainly buy bigger tires on our trucks and four-wheelers to get out in the mud with, so life is good. Whatever I see and I aim at, I shoot. When I shoot it, I kill it, and then I eat it.
So you do kill those ducks?
Of course I do. What are we gonna do, cook them while they're still moving around? My life and my whole eternity belongs to God. All this stuff is temporary. The money, fame, success, temporary. Even life is temporary. Jesus, that's eternal.
Now, as moronic as they try to make him look, he actually says the most intelligent thing in the entire movie.
Hey, we're not trying to offend anybody, all right? If they don't want to watch the show, they can turn the channel.
Oh, look at the happy couple with no problems. They're pretty, but their relationship falls apart because of religion?
Josh, I'm letting you know now for your own good. This experiment is over. You need to prioritize and decide who's the most important person in your life. Me? Professor Radisson.
What if it's God?
No, not even religion. You're just a cunt. Oh my God, I just noticed he has a belief shirt on. Are you serious?
If you're gonna do something as stupid and selfish after I already told you what would happen...
Yeah, but that's sort of the point, isn't it? This is something that's important to me. Right, but since it's not important to you, you made it a make it or break it thing for us.
He's right.
My mother was so right about you. Just wish I'd had the sense to listen.
What the fuck? Another great thing this movie does with their stereotypes. Anyone who doesn't believe in God or puts themselves before God, in the movie's logic, is considered an asshole.
Your role, there's an energy, there's a passion. I mean, you play this role as realistically as I've ever seen anyone play an atheist role. Was that something you had to study? Did you have any sense of the pain of that through some of your own journey?
Yeah, you know what? I've got atheist friends. I've had very good debates with some of my atheist friends. There's only one that will get very angry about things. And I said, why do you get so angry about something you don't believe in? I don't agree with the way they think, but I can play it. It's written in the script.
There is a God, and yet I'm him.
So the greatest scientific mind in all of history says that God is not necessary, but a first semester freshman says, oh, yes, he is.
Mina, this one is awful.
You know, I also checked up on your declared major one, pre-law. What exactly is pre-law? We don't award degrees in that. Don't bother answering.
He took everything away from me.
I'm leaving you.
You can't do that. I won't accept it.
I hate God. All I have for him is hate.
Come on, this is ridiculous. I will make it my personal mission to destroy any hope of a law degree in your future.
You have no idea how much I'm gonna enjoy failing you.
Yeah, just make all atheists look mean. That's a good way to make this movie look legitimate.
I have cancer.
This couldn't wait until tomorrow.
What? I thought you loved me.
I do. But you're changing our agreement. You're breaking our deal. Well, what did you think this was?
I thought it was love.
Grow up, Amy.
What? He's like, you're such a bitch. Why'd you have to get cancer? See what atheists are like? They're all evil and mean. They're all insensitive monsters. You know there are atheists that are good people, right? Sure, there are some atheists who try to shove their own beliefs down other people's throats. But my atheist friends don't do that. They're pretty good people. But no, this movie can't present atheists as good people. Because then the audience will be confused. So we'll just make every atheist in the film a jerk. Let me guess, this character has some troubled past? Someone died in his life, so...
I'm a 12-year-old. Watches his mother dying of cancer. It's only natural to beg God for her life.
Sometimes the answer is no.
Tell that to me the day you lose someone you love.
Yeah, I didn't see that coming at all. He's the bad guy, but he's a bad guy because he had a dark past. You know, not all atheists have traumatic experiences in their life. It's just atheists don't believe in what you believe. They're normal people beside that. They're not all cruel, narcissistic, depressed people. Maybe instead of making this character a stereotype, you can make him more into, like, a realist or something. Maybe make it so he doesn't hate God. Just make him into a very philosophical person. You don't have to make him into an exaggerated asshole. Just someone who believes in something different than the main character, and allows the main character to give a reasoned argument in class.
I'm also a jealous God, so do not try to humiliate me in front of my students.
You told them to go up there, how the fuck did he embarrass you? There is only one kind of interesting subplot in the entire movie, and that is what's going on with this girl. She's like Muslim, I think, but then in secret, she goes against her father and gravitates towards Christianity. This could have been interesting if it was a whole movie, but it's barely developed, and the execution is horrible.
I know they seem happy, but know that when you look around at all those people, there is no one who worships God. Not the way he deserves and demands to be worshipped.
At first I thought, oh, this movie isn't all Christian. It isn't about how everyone should believe in Christianity. It's not just about the Christian God. Maybe it's about all gods. Maybe it's about all religion and how people should respect them. But I gave the movie too much credit, apparently. And I was like, oh, she's a Christian too. All right, never mind.
Give me that! Give me that! You must never tell Baba. Swear to me you will never say anything.
That was a dumb thing to do. Why are you leaving your iPod on like that? You know, someone could sneak in. You're trying to keep the secret, right? Why don't you just take your phone and place it face down? What if you just put the phone in your pocket? What if you just click the button on the top of the iPod that shuts off the screen? I do that all the time when I listen to Alex Jones in secret.
Nelly's going, kill everybody. I get off when I talk about cutting people's power off. I'm a Nelly. All right, I'm not in a good mood now. I start thinking about Bill Gates up there with that little chicken neck. Hopping her now, a little murdering eugenicist. You know how he walks, like a demonic elf. Hey, Bill Gates!
Oh, you didn't do any of that, so this scene could happen. Can we watch that again? Wow. Religion. This is where the more religious criticism comes in. This is kind of hypocritical too. A whole class filled with atheists except for one Christian, and this lone Christian must fight for his beliefs. Meanwhile, in the whole movie, there is only one atheist, which is the teacher. Everyone else is religious and happy and trying to force this message down your throat. The movie's not being smart, the movie isn't raising questions, the movie is telling you how to feel.
How can you hate someone if they don't exist?
Really? The arguments here are very broad and unintelligent. This would never happen in a philosophy class. The way this is executed is so moronic. And again, I'm not saying who I'm taking sides with here, because both of them make valid points. But why doesn't the movie raise more complicated issues with Christianity? Like homosexuality or abortion? Because that might create some controversy, and the audience may disagree with something we said in the film. We don't want the audience to actually think for themselves. We have to tell them how to feel. Look at how great it is! Problem is that this movie is very one-sided. Any number of subplots in this movie can be handled well. And if there was a good director or a good writer and a bunch of producers that weren't trying to push their own agenda, it may be kind of interesting. I, for one, would like to see a movie like this, except with more complicated characters, and where the debates aren't very one-sided and biased. And in case the message of this movie wasn't blatant enough, so the one atheist in the whole movie gets hit by a car and then confesses his devotion to Jesus before he dies.
That car could have killed you instantly. And I'm sure right now you probably wish that it did. But I'm here to tell you that it's a gift. Because a God that you don't believe in has given you another chance.
Get him a doctor!
His ribs are crushed. His lungs are filling with blood. He doesn't have lung.
What? How do you know?
God's not dead. And there's 10,000 of you out there, and everyone knows about 100 people. That's 1,000,000 messages right there. 1,000,000 times, we're going to tell Jesus that we love him in the next 3 minutes.
What happened here tonight is a cause for celebration. Pain.
Yes.
For just a few moments. But now, think about the joy in heaven.
Oh my god. Look at all the characters in our film who believe in Jesus. They're all free and happy and live forever and ever. As opposed to those who don't, who live miserable, lonely lives. Yep. It's official. This movie is a commercial. I feel like I've just wasted my time. Cause this isn't a movie. It is religious propaganda. Once again, I am not saying I am for religion or against religion. What I'm saying is that no matter what my beliefs are, making a 2-hour movie that is meant to brainwash the audience is insulting.
It's really important for Christians to understand the impact that they can have by going to see these movies like God's Not Dead, and supporting production like what Pure Flix Entertainment is putting out. They have an impact on what's happening in our culture and entertainment.
Christians deserve a better movie than this. This is pandering. There are good movies about religion out there. There are good movies about the struggle of believing Jesus or God or whatever. This is not one of them. This is meant to pander to a religious audience, and I think it's meant to make atheists change their minds. If that was one of the goals of the movie, then they failed, because atheists would just laugh at this. And again, you don't show an atheist who actually acts like a human being. If you showed a complicated character and had mixed emotions on what to feel about religion, then maybe atheists could latch onto that character and relate to that character and go through what he's going through. But no, the movie just goes, if you're atheist, you're bad. And then he just gets hit by a car.
What happened here tonight is a cause for celebration.
No one can take this movie seriously. It's laughable to atheists. It's pandering to Christians. It's insulting to Muslims. Like, all Muslims aren't understanding. And when their daughter does something that they don't like, they beat them up. That's how all of them act. But Christians don't do that. All Christians are happy. We're all family. We all get together. This is the message you want to spread? That if you're anything but a Christian, you're wrong?
Why do you keep coming back to do these Pure Flix films? What draws you to
you
do
know,
these?
You know, it's a good product, and there's just such a lack of good family-valued entertainment out there right now. No!
This is not a movie. This is just propaganda. And I can't even say I hate this movie, because this isn't a movie. And how can I hate a movie that doesn't exist?